Hey everybody, Adam Savage at Propstore in London with Stephen Lane. How are you, sir?
Very good, man, very good. Good to see you again, dude.
Dude, I'm so excited because this is like the one place I get to go where there's more spacesuits than I have in my own.
It's not a competition, honestly.
No, I know, it's so thrilling to see all these. Your collection, Stephen has 30, 40 spacesuits?
Dozens and dozens of
iconic pieces of spacesuit movie history. And we're gonna start talking about this beauty here.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. So this is AJ's from Armageddon. This is the suit worn by Ben Affleck in Armageddon. And I think what I really like about this suit is just the fact that it seems to present so different to so many other suits that we've seen come before.
Yeah. You know,
often the spacesuit design through movies is influenced by what's been produced previously, or real life, of course, as well.
Yeah.
Whereas this, it's like, well, they've gone out a bit on a limb, haven't they? And they've taken their own approach to it, really.
It is different I mean, every spacesuit here exemplifies this, you know, a million small choices by art department, by people constructing it, working on set. This one, every choice feels different. Every lat from the heaviness of the material,
yeah,
which feels like the Saris costumes from a Galaxy Quest to, you know, all the little bits of hardware crawling up the sides. Like, why would you do this?
Yeah,
I don't know, but I mean, it's really compelling.
Yeah, and the weight for the actor, you know, to actually wear this, and also the heat in here as well. I mean, can you just imagine how hot it gets inside this suit? It's just astonishing, really.
And, you know, one thing I love about movie spacesuits is they always have to answer the question of how do you see the astronauts,
yes,
right? And, you know, they always have lights in them, and people complain, I'm sure you get it too, where they're like, there wouldn't be lights in an astronaut helmet. Do you know who doesn't care about that? Astronauts. I have friends who are astronauts, and they're like, oh, I'd love lights so I looked a little better in the suit. It looks so romantic. But
does,
this
yeah.
is, until FBFX started to make the Martian and Prometheus suits, this was one of the most open-faced pieces of glass in any spacesuit that I can think of.
Right. Yeah. Yeah. No, it's a wonderful design. And you're right. I think you go back through the sort of design and the development and the process of it. I think all the time they're trying to improve on it. And of course, you know, it's all about the character. It's all about the actor. It's all about getting them screen time. So as soon as you put them in a suit, it's like, how do we resolve that? Of course, we're going to light it up. But then you've also got the problem with it steaming up. And actually, I noticed playing with this earlier on, there's a lot of functionality on here. I think it's this switch here. Let's go. Oh, maybe it's not going to work for me. Oh, there we go.
Oh, the fan works.
So the fan actually works on this still. And so I think that was something that came on quite late as well, is the fact that they realized they had to ventilate these, bring air down over the front of the visor there. Otherwise, it just steams up immediately, doesn't it?
This is a detail I particularly love, is that NASA learned early on that the best way to keep the visor from fogging up was to blow up from the back and around the top because of the convection inside a sphere. And every good movie spacesuit follows the same exact dictum, except that is loud.
Yes.
Because I know that some friends of mine who build suits for films are always working on getting that fan to be as quiet as possible because they want live audio recorded.
Yeah, it almost sounds like we fired up a vacuum cleaner there, doesn't it? Or something like that.
Can you imagine them getting the actors in a suit and then Ben Affleck's like, I gotta take a leak.
Yeah.
Like, all right, we gotta shut down production for an hour.
Yeah, I mean, there's no quick release system there that we can see, is there? I mean, that's, complex to say the least.
So I saw one of these, in a warehouse about 20 years ago and took some pictures because it is such a weird piece. But can we talk about the pants here for a minute?
Sure, yeah.
Because, again, even these boots, you and I were talking off camera about who built this, and I said I felt like whoever built this hadn't built a spacesuit before, and that was like a good thing.
Yeah.
Because
they
were just going in such weird directions with it.
Yeah, I mean, just look at the layers that are on this as well, and just all the add-ons that's just there ultimately for nothing more than dressing, is it? And again, adding some serious weight and volume to that at the same time. But the detailing on it is just superb, isn't it?
Yeah, it's almost like from an art direction standpoint, they're going to the asteroid. And so the suit has to feel like you're on an asteroid.
You're armor plated almost, aren't you? What's coming at me? You know, whereas that's not a thought process for a lot of the spacesuits and for the design. It really feels like they're shielding them with this, doesn't it? As much as anything else.
And then I look at the gloves, I can tell you, I see NASA reference material in this. Because what they've done is they've taken a glove liner And they've made it the outer glove. And a lot of NASA suits have this exact arrangement sort of inside them.
Right, 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 yeah. I mean, it's almost like a rubber gardening glove or something like that, a washing up glove, isn't it? I mean, it's such a such a basic, and actually you can see, unfortunately, how it's degrading over time as well, which is always a consideration. You know, thankfully, the majority of this isn't going to go anywhere, but there are definitely elements to this that we need to be mindful over the years.
Yeah, right. A lot of times they're urethane rubber, so they're nice and stable, but when they're latexes, that's the thing that's really sad. It's like you've got to halt that deterioration.
Yeah, absolutely.
Man, it is such a beauty. Were you able to obtain this piece as a single piece, or did you bring some disparate parts together?
No, thankfully with this particular suit, it actually all came to me as one piece.
Amazing.
Yeah, and I had a lesser suit going back a few years ago, and always with these things, like any form of collecting, you're always trying to upgrade and get to the, you know, and so here we are at the AJ suit now, and I feel like I can't take it any further.
As far as
I need to go with the Armageddon suit, really. But yeah, one of the earlier suits that I had a lot less functionality to this than this suit did, and I don't know whether it had a working fan, for example. And again, you know, in the same way, when film production is working with any costumes, they're always having different styles. They're going to have a lighter weight version, they're going to have the stunt versions, etc. So really we would call this out as a full hero suit. You know, you've got this lovely rotation in the helmet there as well, so you can actually get the head to have some movement that's independent of the collar piece there, which I think is very, very clever. And
I've gone with a very that's a classic. Wow, that's actually machined metal. NASA type neck closure. That is really beautiful. Really nicely done.
Yeah, I mean that you can see there's budget that's gone into this.
Wow.
Isn't there?
Yeah.
There's
seriously.
Time and money that's gone into this to pull this together, and incredibly effective.
Can we talk about the back?
Yeah, sure. Absolutely. Let's come around to the back of the suit here. So
even this backpack is just such a great bit of kit. Like you're talking about the dressing and the painting on the. Various, I don't even know what these are, oxygen canisters.
I assume so, yeah, absolutely. And then you've got dummy versions that sit here that are meant to be sort of interchangeable, obviously, but these are just stunt rubber ones. So you've just got the soft versions that sit in here. But the idea is, obviously, the concept is that they're going to be, I mean, there we go, we've got O2 on here. What's that, X7, O2?
N5,
right.
Nitrogen. Oh, no, X5, yeah.
Yeah, so.
All right.
Oh, there we go. So you got a little bit of functionality on and off there with the... But again, look at all this detail, man.
It's just crazy how gorgeous it is. And I love all this vacuum metalized resin appliques on the sides here.
And maybe some metal work in here as well. I mean, that looks like that's
I couldn't figure out whether that was,
Yeah, it feels like that's aluminium. Oh, there we go. Something's come unplugged.
There's two of those, actually.
Where
did those go?
Yeah, that's interesting, isn't it? They're just sitting loose at the moment.
Oh.
Yeah, in fact, that one's connected. Yeah, there's a few cables here, so there's actually probably more functionality to this than we have it currently running for, but who knows what it's going to be doing.
Yeah. So are you ever tempted, like when someone's like, hey, we're going to head to a Halloween party tonight, to just come in and grab one of these and put it on?
I don't wear the suits, man. Not like you.
That is the difference between
that's
us.
That's exactly the difference.
I wear
between
every
you love wearing
suit.
The suits. No, these stay perfectly preserved on a mannequin. And look, ultimately, that's the difference between a replica suit, isn't it? And also
100%.
One that's been filmed on. You know, for me, it's all about the care and preservation. For you, it's all about, you know, the experience and enjoying it, isn't it, in a very different manner. But it's great that we can both see the different sides of that.
It is really such, this may be one of the weirder pieces in this whole collection. And I love it for how, as we talked about in the beginning, how non-standard its choices are.
Yeah.
Really wonderful.
And we haven't seen this reflected, you know, moving forward either, have we? Nobody's taken this design and gone, oh, you know what? That's the new way to do spacesuits. We should do more of that.
You know, if anybody watching worked on this crew, love to hear comments about it in the comments. We've gotten feedback about stuff before where people have shown up. One of the guys that built Aldo Raine's knife for Inglourious Basterds showed up in the comments.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, very cool.
So I'd love to know any stories that you might have working on this, because even down to just like, how did they get this vacuum form so nice and optically clear? That's non-trivial.
That's tough to do, isn't it?
Oh, it's lovely. Thank you so much for letting us spend some time with this man.
Pleasure.
Amazing. Thank you so much for watching. If you'd like to support us even further, you can by becoming a tested member. Details are, of course, below, but it includes all sorts of perks, and we're building them all the time. You get advanced word and behind-the-scenes photos of some of our projects.
questions. You get to ask direct questions during my live streams, and we have some members-only videos, including the Adam real-time series of unbroken, unedited shots of me working here in the shop. They are weirdly meditative. Thank you guys so much. I'll see you on the next one.